Hey folks, what's happening? In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the differences that a drum riser can have in the sound of a drum kit. I've had a riser set up with my drums here that I've been recording my videos on for quite some time. I got this riser when I was a real young kid from my parents, and they gave it to me for Christmas probably over 10 years ago now. It was really cool when I was a kid. I had lights on it and everything, and it was like I had a little stage for my drums. It was kind of smart on their part too, because we've had water problems in this basement, and it has saved the life of my drum kits a couple times. Those problems have kind of subsided, and so I'd like to experiment and see what the sonic differences are from having a drum kit set up, you know, a couple inches off the ground, and what it sounds like being set up flat on the ground, in this case a concrete floor. So the drums will basically sit in the same spot that they are right now, kind of back into the corner, and we'll hear the differences, you know, room mics, overheads, the whole kit and everything, to hear, you know, really the differences in how the drums ring and resonate and whatnot. And then I'm probably gonna to save some space, because this thing, this riser, has taken up a lot of space, so I'm probably going to maybe push the drums up against this back wall here. So I've got a little bit more room to experiment. You know, the other thing that's been a problem having them a couple inches up off the ground is that I can only then put my overheads up so high, which means I can only have my cymbals up so high. Definitely some stuff I'm going to experiment around with here, but I'm looking forward to hearing the differences, so stay tuned to hear them. Thank you. right, so it's been a couple days since I removed the riser and got the kit down on the floor, and I've listened to the recording a couple times that you just listened to. I did not EQ or compress anything. All I did was kind of set levels and did some slight panning so that it was a little easier to listen to. The main thing that I noticed, and it's very slight, but one of the main things that I noticed was that with the toms and the kick drum, there's a little less decay and ring when the kit's on the ground versus being on the riser. I think that just has to do with them all being on the same isolated platform and them all kind of ringing together a little bit more. You'll hear it, you know, both in just the kick drum mic. And the single tom mics. You know, there wasn't much difference in the snare drum sound, or really anything else that much. It's not like there were any other factors that really contributed to it. I think the main thing to take away from it is that when the drums are on an isolated platform, they're more likely to ring longer and kind of blend together as one. So it's more dependent on what kind of sound you're looking for. I think when you have all the drums mic'd individually, I think it becomes more of a problem when they're isolated and on a riser, whereas now recording it, and I do have it moved into a different position up against the wall, which I can show you some pictures, I think it just makes having all the drums isolated, each with their own individual mic, it makes it a little bit easier to EQ and add a gate if I were to do that. So it's really kind of dependent on how you're miking the kit, you know, and putting it on a riser. You know, if I were just using the two overheads, you know, room mic, maybe kick and snare or something, mainly just not miking the toms, I think having them sing and ring together as one works a lot better on a riser. There weren't too many big differences between the sound. You know, the drums were not dampened at all in either recording. You know, I did play the pattern a little bit differently the second time, so I'm sorry for those who are stricklers about the comparison being as close as possible. But the drums sat in the same spot. I didn't move the room mic. You know, obviously I had to put the microphones back, but I really didn't, you know, change their positioning or anything like that. So, you know, I tried to make it as close as possible, so hopefully you can kind of hear some of those slight differences. Like I said, I'll insert some clips where the mics are soloed so you can kind of hear things a little bit better. I recommend both listening on speakers and with headphones. That was what I did. I think it's a little more clear when you hear it on headphones. So in the grand scheme of things, you know, it's not a huge difference. But like I said, you know, it makes, you know, some of the mixing process a little bit easier, you know, when I have everything individually mic'd when the kit's on the floor. So I hope you enjoyed watching this little comparison and hearing the difference between having a drum kit isolated on a drum riser and having it on a floor. And, you know, if you can build yourself a riser, experiment with it. You know, let me know in the comments kind of the differences that you heard. You know, maybe there's something that you heard that I didn't even pick out or didn't mention. And look forward to hearing what everybody has to say. So thanks again for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you in the next one.